money working. That's the way you do it. Get your money for nothing, get your checks for free. We got to install microwave oven, custom kitchen delivery. We got to move these refrigerators. We got to move these color TVs. Listen here. Now, that ain't working. That's the way you do it. You play the guitar on the MTV. That ain't working. That's the way you do it. Money for nothing and your chicks for free. Money for nothing.
Together on seclosounds.org.
Brilliant, Money for Nothing there from Dire Straits. Thank you for that, Meteor Mick, for finding that song. What a tenuous link to microwaves, which is what we were talking about. We're here on Seclo Sounds, community radio for Milton Keynes. We're with Ross Hockham, as usual, on our special UK astronomy show again.
Yeah,
Talking about radio waves. So just before, we were having a good old chuckle then about that microwave incident.
We were, yeah. There's a couple of others as well that we can talk about later.
Right, okay. So basically somebody cooking a ready meal was interfering with the radio signals coming in.
Yep, the high-tech bit of kit.
Yeah, because exactly. So all this high-tech kit, what has it actually taught us about space then? What have we learned from all of this stuff happening?
Well, I think before microwaves, does anyone know when it was invented, a microwave?
Cool.
Right. Cooker.
It's got to be the early 80s, isn't it?
That's the microwave oven?
That's when we had one.
Yeah.
Well, I think probably the 50s, I think.
That's all right then.
The
50s, blimey, that was early. Well, because these guys, they were in 1964.
Right.
They're the guys, they actually figured out about this cosmic microwave background that we now know about, which I'll come on to. Yeah, so 1964, a guy called, I think it's Arno Penenzias and Robert Wilson. That's an easy one to pronounce.
Yeah, Robert Wilson. We like him, yeah.
This isn't. So they made a Dickey radio meter, which is pretty much a massive radio tower like what we've got today. But, you know, 1964, it probably wasn't as good as what we've got. But I was going to say there's probably less microwaves about, but there wasn't. And they intended to use it for just radio astronomy, just to, you know, do what we do today. But on listening and getting all the data, they found that there was this constant interference in the background, like almost like a constant fuzz, and they just couldn't work out what it was. And they spent ages trying to get rid of it. They thought it was something malfunctioning, bits and bobs going on. They thought maybe they looked around the area and saw if there was anyone else, you know, like driving cars and things like that that might interfere. But it was a constant one. It wasn't up and down. It was just always there. They even dealt with some nesting pigeons because they thought that them might have been interfering with it. So they got rid of them, bless them. Poor pigeons bit the dust. But then they later realised, I think a guy actually phoned them up and said, do you realise what you've got there? And they are actually picking up the remnants from the Big Bang itself.
My word.
So when the Big Bang actually, well, they say exploded, but it didn't really explode, it just expanded. But when it did, it was obviously hot and microwaves were everywhere and radiation and all that sort of stuff thrown everywhere. And it slowly cooled down to where we are today. But there is still that very slight signal from it, from the radio waves. So the Big Bang can still be picked up. And that's when, I mean, I think back in those days, they're all talking about the static universe. So it was a universe that stayed the same, was always there and nothing changed and all this sort of thing. But after finding this, they then realized, well, hang on a minute. That kind of included that there was actually an expanding model. So then from there, it all kind of went into what we know today, or what we believe today is the Big Bang and expanding universe. So thanks to them and their radio telescope, we might never have found that out if it wasn't
That's
for them.
That's amazing. Mm.
When I was a kid growing up in the 60s, there was a big debate about the universe. Is it steady state? Has it always been like this? Or was it a big bang? And in those days, in the 60s, it was steady state was the theory that prevailed. But because of things like what you just described, gradually ideas changed. And now everybody, I think, believes It was the Big Bang.
Yeah, because then Hubble got involved, didn't he? He got his telescope out. I think it was around the same time or a bit later? I think it was around the same sort of 60s. He then realised, you know, he saw the redshift in a galaxy, which meant it was moving away from us. So then all of that pieced together brought evidence to what we believe in today.
Wow.
So that's where
and
it goes.
All that came about as a result of having some fuzz around their massive dickies.
Yep. Yes. You know, if you look at your TV screen, you know when you've just got the static there?
Yeah.
If you look at that, apparently 1% of that static is actually caused by the Big Bang.
No
so
way.
The Big Bang can be picked up by your TV and a bit of that static is the remnants of it.
Wow.
So you can see it today if you go and turn it on. Can you get static anymore on tellies?
Yes,
they're
you can.
All sort of digital and stuff now, aren't they? Cool, yeah. So kids, adults, go home and do that. Might be boring, but one of those little flickers on there, a little bright spark of light, might be a bit of the Big
That's
Bang.
That's amazing. Wow. You know what? My wife fell down the stairs the other day and she said, "You didn't come to help me." And I went, "No, sorry, I thought it was EastEnders starting."
What has that got to do with anything?
I was just thinking, you said television.
Oh, right, okay. Television, EastEnders. Is it time for a song?
It must be. Should we move on?
It must be. Here we go.
You're listening to Seclo Sounds, the community radio station for Milton Keynes.
Listen to the Styx radio show with me, Terry Sullivan, here on Seclo Sounds every Monday from 10 a.m. with guests from the world of entertainment and sport across hearts, beds and bugs. The Styx radio show online at seclosounds.org.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. So here we are. It's Steve Whitten on Seclo Sounds. Welcome back to our UK astronomy program. I'm here with Ross. And we've been talking about radio signals from space. So apart from the microwave incident where somebody was having a ready meal and it was interfering with the radio telescope, what other recent examples or what else has been seen then, Ross?
Well, there was the very famous WOW signal.
Right.
Which it was in August the 15th, 1977.
Mm.
So it was just after all this cosmic background stuff, maybe 10 years after. And yeah, they found a strong narrow band signal was received, apparently, at the Big Ear Radioscope.
Oh.
Great name, Big Ear.
Big Ear.
Big Ear Radioscope. They said it seemed to have come from Sagittarius, the constellation, which, funnily enough, is where the center of our galaxy lies as well. And they do say that our black hole does give off sort of radio waves and X-rays and all sorts of things from that. So they might have picked that up. But they said that it bore all expected hallmarks of extraterrestrial origin.
No way.
So when they saw it, the guy went through all his data. It was Jerry R. Is it Eyman? It's E-H-M-A-N. So I'm going to say Eyman. Or Eman. Yeah, he found it. He found it in some data a few days later. He was going through his data and he was so impressed by it that he circled this bit of data and actually put WOW in red writing next to it.
Okay.
So that's why it's called the WOW signal.
Right.
It lasted about 72 seconds, which is quite long, but it's never been detected since. So no one really knows where it came from. I tried to read up to figure stuff out. One guy said in 2016, which is this year, a paper was put out saying that it might have been caused by a comet. A comet could have had a little burst which caused that. But they looked back to find out what was there, and there were actually two comets up in the sky around that time near Earth, and they said it might have done it, but other people have come out and said, "Now, I don't think you'll get a strong enough signal from that sort of thing for it to, you know, be like that, for the guy to write WOW." And obviously, astronomers don't, well, I know I get excited, but generally scientists don't tend to get too excited until, you know, they sit there and they've correlated it three or four times and made sure it's all good and proper, and then they get excited.
Right.
To see it for the first time and write WOW must have been a massive, where did that come from?
Yeah, yeah. And of course, this plays into the hands of, you know, anyone who believes, and we don't know, do we? So about extraterrestrial life and what else might be going on out in the...
Yeah, all sorts of things. Well, the Russians have picked up a signal recently.
Right.
I don't know where it was from, but they said it was from a nearby star. I'm not sure which scope picked it up. But it's got the catchy name again. They do like a catchy name. HD164595.
Wow.
That's the star. And it's in Hercules, apparently. So it's constellation Hercules. It's 95 light years away and has at least one planet. We found a planet there.
Mm.
So it's not been confirmed yet. You know, it could... There's rumours that protocols might not have been as strict and all this sort of stuff. And
right.
It could be anything. As we've seen, there's been a few mishaps. So it could be anything, really, that has come along. But it could be. There's a planet there. There's a strong signal. I think SETI are on there now having a look to see if there are any more. So there might be aliens doing a radio show.
Right.
You never know.
There might be a parallel universe. There might be three blokes sitting in a studio somewhere in the middle of space doing exactly what we're doing now.
With four arms.
Yeah.
2,000 ears.
Yeah.
Also, in the Facebook group, literally... It's always a couple of days ago. We're always right on the edge, aren't we, of news breaks. There was an aurora, like an alert, red alert, apparently. There was a massive solar flare coming our way, and we were across the UK. You could see it.
Didn't feel a thing.
Nope, nothing happened.